Hello, in this video, I'm going to show how to create quantity takeoffs using the table command to list information of some of the objects that we have in this model. We can run this table command, select any of the styles available, for example, the one that lists walls, click OK, do a selection of the entire model, which will filter the objects that are walls, do right-click, and finally decide an insert point for this table in the model. If we take a look at it, we can see that the table is grouping the walls by style, and we can see the values for the length, area, and volume summed up. We can insert a new table now for the openings. I run the table command, select in this case openings, click OK, do a selection of the entire model, which will filter doors, windows, and openings. And finally, define an insert point. In this case, we have the openings grouped by different properties that will show the common value. Now, let's create a new style. For example, for listing curtain walls, I'm going to do right-click to open the table styles dialog, and I will select new and click on table style, which will open this table style wizard. First of all, I will type the new table style name, for example, curtain wall. Click Next. And now I need to decide which object types I will include in this table. Just notice that in addition to the VisualArQ objects, we can also include Rhino geometry, such as points, curves, poly surfaces, extrusions, meshes, or blocks. In this case, I'm just going to select curtain wall. Click Next. And now I need to add property fields that will be displayed in that table. So I click on Add, type the name of this property field, for example, style, and select the corresponding property. I'm going to add a new one for listing the height, another one for the length, and just another one for the area. I click Next. And here I have the option to group the objects by one of these property fields. For example, I can group all the curtain walls that have the same style. Click Finish. And if I expand this triangle, I will see all the property fields. I can select any of them and change the order. I'm going to move it up to the first position. And now I can insert a table for the curtain walls. I just have three elements, and two of them have the same style, so that's why they appear grouped in the table, summing up their values for the length and the area. If you want to show them listed individually, we just need to edit table style, do right-click on this icon, and delete the quantity property field. We say OK, click Apply, and we'll see the curtain walls now listed individually. If you want to undo this operation and group the elements in table by any property field, we can edit the table style doing right-click on it, select Edit. This will open the table style wizard, so we just need to skip the first steps until the step where we are asked to specify the field in which to group the table elements. So I'm going to select Style again. Click OK, and that's it. Now, I'm going to create a new table style, or basically, I will modify an existing one for listing the information of the slabs. Remember that in a previous chapter, we added some custom parameter for this object, which was the slope. Now, I will show how to list that parameter in a table. So first of all, I'm going to insert the table for listing the slabs information. I can see that in the table style, I have a property field for listing the name, which of course is empty because the slabs don't have any name. So I'm going to replace this property field by another one, for example, a style. And we will add a new property field for showing that slope parameter. I'm going to do right click, here, expand the slabs table, and I'm going to change this property field by the style. So just type the name here, and under the source tab, I need to tell that any object type of any style will take the parameter style. When I click apply, I will already see the changes on the table. Just keep in mind that this table is always linked with the 3D model. Any change on the reference objects will be updated in the table. Now, I'm going to do right click on the slabs on the table style name, select new, and add a new property field. And this would be the slope one. If we try to find the slope parameter under this list, we will notice that it doesn't appear here. And this happens because this parameter was only created by one specific style. So we need to specify here that for a slab object type of that ramp style, I need to select now the slope parameter, which now appears in this list. We click apply, and we will see the values displayed in the table. Finally, we can sort the information in the table by the style. So I'm gonna select slabs, go to the tab sort and add a new criteria. For example, I want to order them by style. Click apply and click OK. Finally, if I want to export any of these tables, I can select that, go to the VisualARQ menu, table, and select export table. And I can save that as an XML file or CSV file.